Good morning, guys. I'm just in the middle of styling my hair this morning. So I am using my FLAXSEED GEL to style, and I've been using the FLAXSEED GEL for like 5 months or so now, and I just wanted to come in with some of the things that I've learned while I've been on the ride of learning how to properly make it and use it. So one of the main things when you're using FLAXSEED GEL is you really need to style your hair in sections. So it's not just easily absorbed into your hair, it's thick. You have to really work it into your hair. So this is what I do. I start from the root and then I come down and then I just scrunch it a little bit. If you just throw it on top of your hair like you would sometimes with a cream or something like that, it's not going to work out for you. It's not going to give you any holds. It might give you a white film that sits on top of your hair. You really want to focus on getting that FLAXSEED GEL to really absorb, which the best way to do it is just raking it through from root to tip. So the other thing that I'm really realizing about my FLAXSEED GEL is the recipe and how I'm making it and how I'm straining it. So I'm just going to break this down real quick. When you make FLAXSEED GEL, no matter what proportion of seeds to water you use, no matter what you're doing, the longer you boil your FLAXSEED GEL for, some people do 3 to 4 minutes, some people do 8 to 10 minutes. The longer you boil your FLAXSEED GEL for, the thicker it gets, and that means two things. When it gets thicker, it gives you a lot better hold. So if you're looking for a light hold, like from a light cream gel, you want to boil your flax seeds for less time and take them out when you see that first kind of stringiness when you pull out the fork. If you have hair like mine, or you like a really hard gel cast for the first day or two so that you get a longer wash and go, then you want to boil it for longer, like 8 to 10 minutes, and it's going to be much thicker. When you pull that fork out, you're going to see that it hangs kind of like this. So the difference that it makes me when you're preparing it is that it is much harder to strain when you do thicker gel the way I do. So I was being lazy for a while. I was making thin gel because it was so much easier to strain it, and you could strain it right through one of like the mesh strainers. You didn't even have to bother worrying about pulling it through a pantyhose, which if you've done that before can be a pain. So I realized I was just being lazy. I was making thin gel so that I could strain it through the strainer instead of having to do it with pantyhose. It was so much easier. It was giving me a lot more gel per batch, but it was not giving me the hold that my hair personally needs. So what I did was I started boiling it longer, and that's when I realized it was giving me better holds, and it was my washing goals were lasting longer, but at the same time, it was really, really, really a pain to strain. So what you have to do is you have to strain it through the pantyhose, which isn't my favorite thing, but what really makes it difficult is when the gel is really hot. Now when you make thicker gel, you want to strain it when it's hotter, because the hotter it is, the thinner it is. As it cools, it gets even thicker. So you have to strain it through the pantyhose, and you have to do it when it's hot, but you don't want to burn your fingers off, which is why I never liked using the pantyhose method in the first place. So I came up with a neat little trick. You guys are probably gonna make fun of me. You know I do weird stuff when it comes to making sure things work for my hair. But what I did was I took a thin pair of winter gloves, and I put on a thin pair of latex gloves over that. And that gave me the heat protection against like my palms from the winter gloves, because it just is a little bit thicker. And then I had the glove on top of that to protect the gloves from getting all sticky. So literally I had double set of gloves on, and that's how I strained all the gel through the pantyhose. And honestly, it worked so good.
Right. My AI just changed. It just buzzed the front gate. I thank God you came. How many more days could I wait?
It made it so that I can make really thick gel so my washing goals last a lot longer. And it also made it so that I could strain it easily without waiting for it to cool, because that's when it gets thicker. And also without burning myself. So there you go. If you're making FLAXSEED GEL at home, you want to definitely remember that just like this, section by section you want to go through. Section by section, and really work that gel in there. Don't just let it sit on top of your head. You're gonna get much better results. when you're making it, regardless of the recipe you use, which I have a recipe in my highlights and I have a recipe on my YouTube channel. I really should make an updated YouTube video though, now that I make it a little bit differently. But you want to make sure you want a lighter hold. You're boiling it for less time, maybe 3 to 5 minutes. And if you want that really strong hold, then you're gonna be boiling it for more so like 8 to 10 minutes. And you're gonna be there with it the whole time stirring. So just make sure that you realize when you're getting to a point where it might be getting just thick enough for you, and that's when you wanna take it off. Don't forget to double up your gloves if you're gonna be straining it. You don't wanna wait till it cools down too much or it's gonna be very thick. And you don't wanna burn yourself. And of course, you want to remember to refrigerate your flaxseed gel, because it will start to smell. It's natural, it's no preservative. So you know things are good for your hair when they actually go bad from being made out of real products. So this is my results. I have a lot of definition, a lot of shine. Obviously, it's still very wet. I just finished applying the flaxseed gel, but yeah, I figured that since I'm finally coming back, I wanted to get in here first and say, wow, I've been using flaxseed gel this whole time, and it's still my favorite styling product. Just sometimes you can do things a little bit different to make it better. So please leave any questions or comments below. I appreciate you guys watching, and I hope these tips help you and you get just as good of results.
It don't work like that when you lost somebody. My old flex is my new flex.